let's get back to the show. We are very excited, as I mentioned before. This is a gentleman we've been eager to have on this program for quite a long time. He is a brilliant songwriter. He writes songs about people and subjects nobody else does. And this is his latest album right here, entitled Trouble in Paradise. We're very happy he could be with us tonight. Please welcome the one, the only, Mr. Randy Newman.
Hate New York City, cold and it's damp, and all the people dressed like monkeys. Let's leave Chicago to the Eskimo. That town's a little bit too rugged for you and me, you bad girl. Saturday and the wind's blowing hot from the north, and we were born to ride. Roll down the wind, put down the top, crank up the beach, boys, baby, don't let the music stop. We're gonna ride it too, just can't ride it no more. From the south, baby, to the valley, from the west side to the east side. All the time, look like another perfect day.
Thank you very much. Randy Newman is here. Very nice, Randy. Nice to meet you. Thank you very much for being on the program.
Pleasure.
We were discussing, among other things, this afternoon whether or not this song, I Love L.A., was something you actually felt, or was it tongue-in-cheek or sarcastic?
Well, I feel it. I love L.A. The streets I picked, you know, are not the Champs-Élysées.
Victory Boulevard, yeah, that's not
good. Yeah, and Century Boulevard. But, I choose to live there.
Yeah.
Nice weather, nice people, great cultural center.
No, you're kidding, right?
No.
I like this picture because this is just right down the street from where I used to live.
Yeah, in the Pacific Palisades.
Yeah, you can just barely see Point Doom up there.
I used to go there when I was a kid.
Point Doom?
All by myself. No, the beach there.
Yeah.
I took that.
It's a beautiful area.
Yeah.
Let me ask you about also on the appearing on this record, the album, Linda Ronstadt, mm-hmm. Wendy Waldman, Jennifer Warrens.
That's right.
Don Henley, Bob Seger. Ricky Lee Jones, no. Lindsey Buckingham.
See, now you don't have to go to rock and roll heaven.
Paul Simon.
Yeah.
Working with those people on
Jimi
your
Jimi Hendrix was going to come back for it, too. But
does that make you nervous, working with those folks?
Well, you know, I'd want to quit early. I'd say, oh, we got it. You know, there'd be a lot of mistakes, and I'd say, oh, that's good enough. But they love my music so much, they just want to keep working and working and working. I couldn't get Paul out of the studio. He'd just stay there, hour after hour. It didn't really make me, you know, I have nothing but contempt for anyone who's successful anyway. So they must be doing something dishonest, you know.
Yeah.
So it didn't bother me.
I would think that all of those folks hovering about while you were conducting a recording session would be some pressure.
No, I didn't feel it. They were very, very nice bunch of people. You know, I'd like to still be able to, you know, dislike Fleetwood Mac's music, or but you can't. They were too competent and too nice, and we're best of friends now.
Well, good. I'm glad you got that worked out.
Yeah.
I read an interesting article in a magazine not long ago. Mentioned you and your family and so forth. You have a son who is also a musician.
Well, yeah, he's a musician.
What's this? This is Amos?
Yeah, it's his birthday today.
Oh, happy birthday, Amos. How old a man is he now?
He's 15 now.
15. Yeah. He's in a band?
He was in a band called Smashed Infant.
Is this like a church group or something?
Yeah, very much like that. They changed their name. They thought that was a little rough, so they changed it to Armed Response. It's sort of a fascist outfit. And, I think he's sort of broadening his taste now a bit, but he's in a different kind of band. But I haven't, you know, I haven't been keeping track too much.
Now, they mentioned in the article that perhaps their signature piece was a song about... A popular television celebrity.
They had a song. They played me their songs. A couple of them were about, "We're not going in the army. We're not going in the army." And I said, "Well, you know, no one wants to go in the army." And
plus,
and
you're
so,
14.
What are you so
you
mad
know?
About? Yeah. And it's probably better than being at home, you know. But they had a song about Ted Knight. You know, like, you know, it's a long way from blowing in the wind. He's honorary mayor, and they've seen him around and took an instant liking to him. And the song went, you know, "Ted Knight, you old has-been, we hate you, you know, we're going to beat you up." And I said, "You know, what are you doing? I mean, what's the point? He's a decent fella, you know what? We don't like him." I said, "Why don't you like him? He didn't do anything. They just saw him sitting somewhere." Uh-huh. And he had a shirt that said Ted Knight, you know.
And they anyway. Musically have put him in his place.
Yeah.
What do he and his friends enjoy your music? They must be under your influence musically, don't you think?
No, I don't know. You know, he came to see me when I played the amphitheater, and he was sort of impressed that all those older people came out to see me. I don't know. I think he's proud of me, but it's hard to say.
Yeah. I'm sure he's
proud. He'd rather break windows, I think.
No. Now, what, do you ever have occasion to play them music that you like, or?
It's hopeless, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, now he's changing a little bit, you know, their stuff. He'll listen to Rush now.
Yeah.
So I just bought him some Rush records. But before that, you know, it was, I hate to do this to him on his birthday, to exploit him this way. And before that, it was, you know, the Sex Pistols were just too easy going. That was real middle of the road stuff.
Well, but he sounds like he's beginning to soften up now. That's good.
Yeah, he's a little. Yeah.
Randy, are you going to be able to do another song for us?
Yeah, I could.
We got to go away for station identification. Don't worry about nothing. We'll be right back with Randy Newman. Thank you, Paul. Welcome back. Later on in this program, we'll be taking you to Coney Island. Also, you're going to meet the wilderness survivalist Tom Brown Jr. Tomorrow night, Cheryl Teagues will be here, along with Jeff Altman and cowboy Casey Tibbs. So, you know, the security will be extra tight tomorrow night. Now, by the way, the video that goes with I Love L.A. is terrific.
Oh, thank you.
That's very
really,
nice.
It's fun to do.
You driving around in a big gas
guzzling.
Yeah,
with a pretty girl. It's great life being an actor. You know, you don't have to think of anything to say. It's all down there for you.
Yeah.
It's great.
Turned out nicely.
Thank you.
I didn't realize until this afternoon that in addition to all of this music that you've been responsible for, you're also the author of a soft drink commercial.
Yeah, really,
words and lyrics.
A Dr. Pepper commercial. It was a contest. I didn't know what it was. They said, "Would you like to write a Dr. Pepper commercial?" And I said, "Well, I'll try." And so I submitted it. And it turned out they had 250 other people submitting it, but they used mine.
No.
Briefly, at least. It was before that dancing guy. I'm a pepper. It wasn't that one. Mm-hmm. In fact, I can't even remember mine after that one.
Now, what motivated you to enter a jingle writing contest for Dr. Pepper?
The artistic sort of freedom they gave me.
do you
and I love Dr. Pepper, you know.
Do you really?
Sure.
Now, you don't remember it at all how it went?
Yeah, the most original... It went like Birmingham. I saw Birmingham. It's the most original soft drink ever in the whole wide world. And then they go, Dr. Pepper. It's really a lot of fun.
Yeah. Sure. And
I liked it better than that, the one they had after that. The one they had before it, I liked better than mine.
Yeah.
But I don't remember it.
Will, is this the one that you were involved with, this Dr. Pepper commercial at all?
Oh, sure.
Really? It's a big favorite. Yeah. Musicians just love playing it, you know. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All the musicians would go play it at their house and everything.
Yeah, we're up to the Dr. Pepper part now, Will. It's probably the jet lag from the Orient. You also, there was a time in your life when you were worked for a publishing company, a record company, writing hits?
Just right. Well, no, I didn't write any hits, but you can't accuse me of that. But I was trying, you know, I try to write follow-ups for people.
Mm-hmm. And, anything come to mind there? Who were the artists for whom you were writing?
You know, anybody. It was the thing, let's see, the Fleetwoods, when I started a long time ago, mm-hmm. Gene McDaniels was there, Bobby V, things like that. One label, a long time ago, back in the Pleistocene era.
And you would write the songs that...
I would write the songs that they would turn down and do songs by Carole King.
But you were also on the other, the B-side, as they say, of other...
Yeah, a couple times of a Fleetwood's hit now and then, you know, kept me alive.
Yeah.
So it was nice.
What is the song you're going to do now, Randy?
I think I'll do Political Science, or Let's Drop the Big One.
Okay, and... Is there anything you want to mention? Or?
No, it's about U.S. foreign policy. In Europe, they thought it was a joke when I played it there.
All right.
I'll play it.
Okay. Randy Newman, ladies and gentlemen.
You all right?
Political Science.
No one likes us. I don't know why. We may not be perfect, but heaven knows we try. But all around... Even our old friends put us down. Let's drop the big one and see what happens. We give them money, but are they grateful? No, they're spiteful and they're hateful. They don't respect us, so let's surprise them. We'll drop the big one and pulverize them. Asia's crowded, Europe's too old, Africa's far too hot, and Canada's too cold. South America stole our name. Let's drop the big one, there's no one left to blame us. We'll save Australia. Don't wanna hurt no kangaroo. An all-American amusement park there. They got surfing too. Boom goes London and boom Paris. More room for you and more room for me. In every city, the whole world round, will just be another American town. Oh, how peaceful it will be. We'll set everybody free. You wear Japanese kimono, babe, it'll be Italian shoes for me. They all hate us anyhow. So let's drop the big one now. Let's drop the big one now. Thank you. Thank you.
Terrific, Randy. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.
Randy Newman, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back. Take a visit to Coney Island.